The windows of heaven for me. Money go there.
Jesus!
Good day, everyone. This is Dan Sandu, the most handsome, capable, athletic, pumping, and physical husband. And as usual, I have beside me my most scintillating, pepperoni, sugar, vicious, hot baby girl.
Good day, hello world, and today you're welcome to the Cetrus blog of the Cetrus family. This is Jacquette Oliver and Cetrus, and it's a pleasure having you around. In case you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the notification bell. And say thank you to all that have been supporting. And today, we want to discuss something so interesting and at the same time, not interesting. And why is that? This current situation, the current challenging situation of hunger in the land of Nigeria and most African countries has brought out two sides of the human beings.
Some youths are able to manage the situation by changing the challenging life experience into what we call comedy or comic. But those that do not have the ability to water down the challenging moment with comedy, they are really going into robbery and a lot of vices.
Okay, and that's the case. They want to start with this very funny word.
The windows of heaven for me. Money go there.
Jesus!
70 years old, man.
Lift your voice and sing.
Not be juju be that.
Thank you.
Okay, having seen that video, we want you to comment in the comment section below. What do you feel about this? You guys just felt, so far I don't have the food to eat, I have the solid, I don't have the soup, I don't have what to eat with it. I'm just taking it.
And it's a pointer to those of you that used to flash your food on Instagram. One of the days your pot will be empty. Because people are really hungry and they will start eating from Instagram.
Okay, right now we go to the more serious cases. Yes, we are seeing youths right now taking out to social vices of robbery, vandalizing people's car, and what have you. There's this case of this popular TV presenter here in Nigeria. She was just robbed right there, as in it was God that saved the life. Just take a look.
Document what happened, because I know that sometimes we report these things and people don't take it serious. So coming from, I just finished an event at a hotel this evening, and I was driving back home on the bridge, the K2 bridge from Third Mainland, the bridge that takes you towards 7-Up. I got robbed. They damaged my car. Some two guys flanked me. They were hitting on the car that I should wind down, wind down, wind down. And as they were hitting, they broke the side. They broke the side mirror, caused a little bit of injury on my hand. I was just very shaken. I thought I should just drive first to TVC. Let me come and calm down in TVC, and then I'll go back home. But I reported this thing on Wednesday. I reported that somebody got robbed in that same place on Wednesday. I said it on the show. I said we need to have more security presence there. There were police people there, but they were by the van. The robbery took place after the van, and they were young boys, came to the side of the car. I know that it was God. I was able to just swerve left and right. I'm going to head back home, try and dust off all the glass from my body, but we can't afford to do this. Everywhere there's traffic, there's a risk to our life, and the government needs to do much more than this.
Looking at that, I tell you, is to tell you the kind of situation that the youths in Nigeria, in Africa, across the globe are going through. And that's why attention needs to be paid to these youths. The next video we're going to be showing you is another one that is so painful. We are going to see how two individuals on separate grounds, separate days, they were being robbed, as in they vandalized their cars to the point that it was just the empty carton of the car that was left behind. Or let me put it in a better way, is the carcass of the car that is left behind. Just have a look at this.
See my car. 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 Baby, come here. Come. See my car. See my car. See my car.
All right, see what I woke up to this morning. Side mirror, one gone. Full light gone. Sockets, plug gone. Battery gone. Another light gone. And brain box. Brain box is also gone. The control for both sides. The master controls on both sides for the mirrors gone.
This passenger side mirror
broken. Backlight broken, taken, gone. Gone. My car is literally
And like you rightly heard that TV presenter said, it was said of young guys, youths that robbed her. And to help these youths get out of this, we know there are some of them that are actually addicted to this evil, but some were pushed into it because of hunger in the land. And to help them get out of these vices, that's why we're advocating always right here on this channel that we have to reach out to these youths, empower them. Nobody wants to learn. Take them off the street. That's what we're doing with our foundation called the Central Foundation. We're reaching out to the interiors. We're going to the villages in Africa. We even have some connections right now outside Nigeria, different African states. They're just waiting for us to enforce them. That they're taking youths off the street, teaching them the particular crafts they're interested in, helping them know that craft, helping them sell their skills to the larger community. And I think that's just what we have to think about. So, because if you just think you'll save and you'll save out there, be so sure that these youths are coming out for everywhere.
And let me tell you, the youths you are trying to help do not necessarily need to be your family member. Because if you are looking at it that he's not my family member, I'm not going to help this youth, one of these days, he's not your family member that have access to you most of the time. Most of the time, is youths around your vicinity that will begin to look at you, that they can't eat but you can eat. You become an automatic threat to them if you are not assisting them to get out of their possible challenges. And that is why, this December, we are looking at a two-way project, one of which is how to identify these youths that are really going through challenging moments and need help. Look at that. Needs help. It's not all youth that need help, but the few that need help, they need support. They need somebody to help them to get a means of livelihood so that they don't get drained into the world of corruption and vices. Central Foundation is coming up. Then the other aspect is that just like last year, we fed over 100 families with free live chicken and some foodstuff. This year, we are looking at how we can do 1,000 families. And if you are out there, you want to support us on this mission, kindly reach out to us via the comment section, or you support us via our PayPal or our GoFundMe account. And you can also reach out personally to us on our WhatsApp number displayed below. If it's just two families you will be able to take care of, or four families, or 10 families, or 100 families, kindly indicate so that we can put smiles across families that are going through turbulent moments during this Christmas.
And we're doing this with the major aim of actually discovering these youths from these less privileged families in their rural forms. So while we're reaching out to them with the foodstuffs, with the free chicken during this Christmas, we try to tell them, bring your youths that are interested in particular craft. We go them through the let them go through a particular test. We make sure we know actually what they're interested in, not just any interview. And once they're successful, we'll be able to help out in empowering them so that they don't keep begging, and we can have a safer society, community, wherever we are in Africa and outside Africa.
For those of you that used to take one-way drive, I have this interesting video that has been shared. about a young man or a family man that decided to drive on a one-way lane. Unfortunately, he met with the military guys and they asked him to stand on his car and be waving everybody a goodbye. I think that's so funny.
So funny. So that's just it. Don't forget the joy therapy. I want to say thank you to all that have been reaching out to the Searchers Foundation, blessing the life of these youths. You see a profile, you can see what these youths have been achieving. Just an update on all our youths that we've helped so far. Just check the link below.
And please don't forget, if you're in Nigeria, you have foodstuffs that you can donate to us as a foundation to share to these families that are going through challenging moments. If it's 1 bag of rice, 10 bags of rice, 100 bags of rice, even we can even exceed the 1,000 families that are talking of. If it's tomatoes, if you're a farmer and you'll be able to give us some farm crops or whatever, food crops or the like, please, we'll be happy to donate to more families.
Okay, and that's just it. Remember, your joy is your strength. Whatever happens, make sure you don't lose your joy. Yeah. And whatever you're going through, do remember that there's a family that are interested in you. Just reach out to the Searchers. We love you. We care about you. Catch you and see you will come your way in the next video you may like to watch.
This video
of this.